What's up, everyone? I'm here in downtown Clearwater, Florida, and I'm going to be driving on the Gulf Coast all the way down to St. Pete Beach. Right in front of me is the Fort Harrison building, the headquarters for the Church of Scientology, and I'm going to make my way over to Clearwater Beach, which is over to the right. Right now, there's a free park and ride going to the beach. I was able to get to the beach for free by parking in the City Hall parking lot and taking a free shuttle. I estimate this drive should take about an hour if there's no traffic, but we'll see how it is. Clearwater is the county seat for Pinellas County. There's actually a lot of cars leaving Clearwater Beach now. When I took the shuttle over to the beach, it was kind of busy over here. This is the Clearwater Memorial Causeway. We're still on the causeway just a little bit more until we get to Clearwater Beach. Directly to the south of Clearwater Beach is Sand Key, and after that is Bel Air Beach. Right now the time is just about 5 o'clock p.m. It's Thursday, March 16th, 2023. Temperature right now is 76 Fahrenheit, 24 Celsius. See if I can get rid of this streak on the windshield. I think it's staying. Coming up is the traffic circle. To the right is Mandalay Avenue, the main business area in Clearwater Beach. Here's Coronado Drive, going south. As you can see, it's quite busy at the beach right now due to spring break. Looks like we're all merging here. Hyatt Regency Hotel right here. Big pink building. One hour free parking at this garage. We might even get stuck in traffic here. A lot of this traffic's caused by this construction. Let's let these people cross. The Edge Hotel. Most of the hotels in Clearwater Beach are located over here. And turn into the driveway faster than I could change lanes. Looks like UPS is in the lane. This is the end of Clearwater Beach. We're going to be driving to Sand Key now. This bridge is so unbelievably steep. There's a few hotels over here too. As I drive down Gulf Boulevard, we're going to see signs depending on the next municipality. Like here, we're still in Sand Key, but soon we're going to see signs for Bel Air Beach. Then after that, I think it's called Bel Air Shores. There it is, city of Bel Air Beach. Each of these places around the along the Gulf Coast are very unique from each other too. Thing at the rate traffic is going, this might take me longer than an hour to finish. So the left is the Bel Air Beach Causeway. I think we're about to approach Bel Air Shore soon. Here's First Street. Yeah, this has to be Bel Air Shores. Well, welcome to Indian Rocks Beach. I don't even know where Bel Air Shores was, but this is Indian Rocks Beach now. I know Indian Shores is after Indian Rocks Beach. Then there's other beaches like Reddington Beach, Madeira Beach, and Treasure Island. There's a lot of cool little spots to stay at. Here's the Sea Star Motel on the left, Sunset Paradise. There's a pretty active crosswalk. think coming up here is the entrance to the causeway. Junction 688, Walsingham Road. And the main beach access to Indian Rocks Beach is to the right. A lot of cars here. Busy area. You have to be really careful with these pedestrian crossings. Here's First Avenue, so I'm expecting the sign to change and lead us to Indian Shores. There's the sign to the left, Indian Shores. It's a cool little vehicle this person has in front of me. Fun for cruising over here on Gulf Boulevard. cool little strip mall to my left, the Bay Mariner. I shouldn't be in this lane for Pinellas Park. Usually the right lane is for the through traffic here. Madeira Beach, 4 miles. Treasure Island is 7. Not sure how far St. Pete Beach is. St. Pete Beach was rated the number one beach in the United States a few years ago. Here's Reddington Shores. Reddington Shores welcomes you. Looks like it's getting a little bit more commercial here. There's a cool spot along Gulf Boulevard called John's Pass. I'm not exactly sure which section it is. But there's a lot of cool like little restaurants and bars there. Here's the North Reddington Beach city limit. And as you can imagine, Reddington Beach is after North Reddington Beach. Well, that was really abrupt, the turning. Here's the actual Reddington Beach. There's the sign to the right, Town of Reddington Beach. I see some police activity here. What happened? Pinellas County Sheriff. Oh my goodness. Oh wow. That's not good. That is a really bad crash. Hope everyone's okay. But just goes to show you, you have to be really careful driving here. Here's the Madeira Beach city limit. I saw a little tiny sign to the right. Actually, let's go on the right lane. Madeira Beach City Hall is to my left. as well as the library. Looks like St. Pete Beach is 6 miles away, Treasure Island's 3, so not bad. I thought it was going to be a little bit longer. I think these people need to cross the street. Bridge work ahead, use caution. I think John's Pass is straight ahead of me to the left. It kind of looks like it. It's very familiar. But very neat area to hang out at. There it is, John's Pass Village and Boardwalk. And here's the bridge to the next area. Treasure Island city limit. There's a lot of motels here in Treasure Island. Looks like you can access the beach from here. We should be exiting Treasure Island soon. First Street, next circle, next light, and here's St. Pete Beach. Actually, I need to go this way for Gulf Boulevard and St. Pete Beach. It took me about 50 minutes to get to St. Pete Beach. Welcome to Sunset Beach. I think I need to turn around and go back the other way where I made that turn. I'm still on Treasure Island. Definitely a cool area. I didn't even know this was here. Here at Gulf Boulevard, or West Gulf Boulevard. We need to go to the actual Gulf Boulevard. Here we are, right turn. And this is the correct way to St. Pete Beach. Welcome to St. Pete Beach, sunset capital of Florida. I got lost, but thankfully I was able to get right back on track here. I see Gulf Boulevard is actually to my right, but that's very residential there. St. Pete Beach to the right, South Pasadena to the left, and Corey Causeway to the right. Okay. This is definitely the right way now. Okay, Gulf Boulevard left. Still kind of lost where I am. A lot of hotels and resorts here. See anybody in the crosswalk? Beach access next signal. Parking in there. right. Here's the Don Cesar Hotel. Very iconic building here in St. Pete Beach. To the left is the Pinellas Bayway going back to the mainland. I've been inside this hotel. It's absolutely gorgeous. These homes here are so gorgeous. And Gulf Boulevard ended. This became Pass-a-Grille Way. I'll turn right here. The Gulf sunset is hitting me right now. Drive this all the way to the end. a really neat little area. Brass monkey. Alright everyone, thank you for joining me on this drive from Clearwater to St. Pete Beach, or historic Pass-a-Grille now. I really drove far, but I want to thank you all for watching today. Hit that like button if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time. Bye everyone, take care.